Welcome back to part two of the painting of the Rebel 68 Dodge Hemi Dart of Larry Griffith that I'm doing. One of the things I didn't mention in the first part when we were laying down the silver base coat is that in between a couple of those breaks that I took and went away and came back, I let the paint dry for about an hour in between one of the in between coat two and coat three. As I said, I didn't realize my camera had quit, my battery went dead. I actually thought I had some of this on video, and I wound up when I looked at the video, I didn't. I had said that during that time that I was laying down such light coats that it did take about four complete coats. And when I say coats, I'll make two or three passes on one side with acrylics because they dry so very fast, so you're actually not getting it too wet. Now, these Aztek acrylics are no exception. They dry very quickly. By the time you get around, you start on one side and you go around and you do your top and your trunk deck and, the other side. And by the time you come around back to where you started, your paint pretty much, for all practical purposes, is already dry. The exception to that is when you mix Future in with any of your paint, like craft acrylic or whatever. Future, you don't want to do more than one coat at a time. Future takes about a good 30 minutes to 40 minutes to dry. If you attempt to paint more than one coat at a time with Future, you'll notice it after it dries. If you put two coats at once, you'll come back, and then when they dry, you'll see runs in it. So another tip, if you're mixing craft acrylic and Future, you definitely won't let the Future set up and dry for a good 30 minutes before you attempt to add another coat. In other words, one coat at a time, let it dry for 30. That's why a lot of people shy away from the craft acrylic with the Future. It's a long process. Four or five coats is going to take you, every bit of probably a couple of hours to 2.5 hours. So that doesn't bother some people. It doesn't bother me. So at any rate, we're going to go ahead and let me close one of these windows down because it's getting a little light in here. The sun's starting to come in kind of bright. All right. We're going to start to put the blue, pearl blue, down, and we'll go ahead and get it ready. Same as before with the silver, we're going to do light coats, probably about four, since I am shooting pretty light coats. And it, I almost didn't do this today because it is bone chilling cold here, and it's about 5 degrees outside, so I have it controlled in here to about 70 degrees, so I think we'll be okay. So there's our pearl blue. Ready to go. We're going to get our air compressor turned on and get our gun. And another thing I wanted to mention too, I have on this hose a moisture evaporator, and all that is just catches, it traps moisture in this little cylinder. And you unscrew this at the end of your paint session, and it catches water, and you just drain it out. And if you buy this, all you do is, it comes with the connections on both ends, the fittings. You just cut your hose, put the fittings on both sides of the hose, put this in, push it up on there, tighten it down, you're ready to go. You do want to put this as close to the gun as you can, so that if you put it way down here, at the middle of the hose, then you have that much more opportunity for water to get past it and then get into your gun. So you put it right here towards the end. It does kind of get in the way every once in a while, but it's worth its weight in gold as far as I'm concerned. So especially here in Tennessee where the humidity is so bad, and the moisture trap down at the air compressor doesn't do much good a lot of times. So all right, we're ready to go. We've got our gun set to, or our compressor rather, set to 26 pounds. All right, let's see what happens. like I said, we're going to be shooting real light coats. The blue will be a little easier to see. Thing about these also, if you're shooting real fine coats, check your tip on your airbrush from time to time because they will dry at the tip. And a little ball of paint will solid up on the end and you won't be shooting any paint. So you have to watch that a little bit as well. Get a good light base coat set, then I'll heavy up on the coast just a little bit. Alright, now we've come back around to where we started. As I said, you're good, pretty good with your mist coats at two coats before you need to stop for dry time, at least with these paints anyway. We'll get back around this third time. I'm going to open up the brush just a little bit. And we'll start to lay down a little bit of a wetter coat. And we'll probably put three of those down. Now this blue that I'm shooting now is the same blue that I painted the 67 Chevy Malibu for the Chevy cheeseburger to be built. Go back through the archives and look at that. I didn't do that on camera, but kind of gives you an idea how well these paints turn out if you take your time. And they hold up real well to clear coat. You can shoot these with pretty much any kind of clear coat. I clear coated that one with Testors Wet Look Clear lacquer, and then went back with fuchsia right at the very end. Okay, I'm gonna open up the brush just a little bit so we can lay down a heavier coat. And then after that coat, we will stop and let that coat dry, and we'll come back for the final couple of coats. So let's start and see what we got here. Yeah, there we go. I'm getting a nice, deeper blue color on there. When I start doing my heavier coats, I go all the way across the top instead of side to side like I did earlier. if at all possible you want to, craft acrylic sometimes it's a little hard to do. You want to start off of your subject, start your spray, and don't stop till you come off of the subject. Now I know you've seen me probably paint with some of the craft acrylics that I'm doing a little short burst, and I do that, the reason I do that is because craft acrylics sometimes will spit a little bit even after they've been mixed up, and I have a battery powered paint mixer. They will even spit up sometimes like that with paint mixed up with a mixer. So I'll stop a lot of times and look and see what my paint is doing. These paints here, you don't have to worry about that. They are, like I said, pre-thinned, and you really don't have to do that. So, all right, we're going to stop right there, and I'm going to stop the video, and we'll let that much dry. We'll come back, and we'll finish up with a couple more wet coats. See you back soon. All right, it's been about an hour. I'm going to start shooting in a couple of wet coats. Get our air compressor turned back on. I also cleaned my tip while I was letting everything dry there. All right, let's go ahead and get started. I wouldn't recommend that you spray in your paint booth without your extractor on, even with acrylic paint. I'm just doing this for demonstration purposes so that it's not so hard to talk or for you to hear. It's a good practice, even, you know, if you're shooting acrylic paint, to have your extractor on and wearing your respirator. Breathe enough crap as it is in the real world. We don't need to add to it in our home, so our workshops or wherever you happen to be spraying. And notice I'm staying about 6 to 8 inches away. That seems to be good for these paints. I've never had these paints run, so we'll keep our fingers crossed and hopefully that trend continues. All right, that's another couple of coats, so we're going to stop right there and let those two coats dry, and we'll be right back. All right, it's been about an hour, so we're going to go ahead and put a couple of more wet coats on, and I think that will be enough. After it dries, we'll see if it's the light in here. What you're seeing is quite a bit lighter than it actually is on the car. The car is a little bit deeper blue, and I'm glad, because his car is more of a deep dark blue. Not overly deep dark, but it's much darker than it looks to you, at least through this viewfinder anyway. So, all right, we've got our gun set to 26, our compressor set to 26 pounds. We'll go ahead and Go ahead and get started. Finish up our wet coats. All right. Starting to take on a good, nice, deep, dark blue. Almost a pearl, real nice pearl blue finish. Almost a candy is what I meant to say. And I apologize if my arm is blocking, when my arm blocks the camera, I know it is. I need to have my laptop in here where I can see what I'm, see what you're seeing. All right, I'm going to take, since we've been away a couple of times, we'll do a little shortcut trick here. Not a trick to those of you who have been airbrushing for a long period of time, but you can take. Don't think that you have to have a double action airbrush to use the air from your compressor to dry your paint, because you don't. You can just turn off your paint flow where you're not spraying any paint, and you can use your air from your gun to, if you're in a big hurry. I'm not a big fan of that. I'm just doing it to kind of show you can do it. If you've got any trash, of course it happens if you've got paint in there as well, but with the air, you can't see it as well as if you get trash and paint. The paint will stick in the paint, and you can see it when it hits the body, and you can get it off before it dries. Whereas with air, if you're blowing dust, you can't see it till it's too late a lot of times. So, but I've wet the inside of this booth down. I haven't seen any so far. So, all right, we've got that done and pretty much dried enough to shoot another coat or two. Probably be the final coats we put down. I believe we're getting to about the deepness of color that we want. I believe that will pretty much get it. Let that dry, and later on I will be painting the hood and the one of the rear body panels that go on between the bumper and the hood deck. And the hood scoop, I'll do that off camera. So that pretty much gets it done, I think. I hope you've been at least gotten a little something out of this, and you've been able to see that these paints are very good paints. They shoot very well. They're low maintenance, if you will. Nothing to them as far as you don't have to worry about thinning. Reasonably priced, compared to like House of Color and things like that. And they're friendly as far as if you don't have a place where you can shoot lacquer during the winter time. I have this paint booth that I exhaust outside, but it is inside the house. And even with a good extractor and I'm right by a window, you wind up with fumes in the house. So I think we'll call this one finished. I'll go ahead and let it dry, and I'll shoot some clear coat on it. I haven't decided if I'll come back with future right at first, or if I'll go ahead and brave the elements and raise this window and shoot some Testors wet look clear on it. I don't want this car overly shiny, because it wasn't overly shiny. It was a nice looking car, but race cars by nature are not high gloss cars, especially funny cars these days. They're fiberglass. There's only so much you can do to them, a clear coat and that's it. So I'm going to clear coat it with something, a couple of coats, and then leave it, and we'll be through with it. So, all right, I think we'll call this one finished. Hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you for watching. Thank all my subs for subscribing. Until I talk to you again, take care of one another. May God bless you and your family. Just build it. Talk to you soon.